Hello. Today I was reading about sharing knowledge. Keeping knowledge erodes power. Sharing is the fuel to the QR growth engine. Share your knowledge. It's a way to achieve immortality. So the knowledge has to be shared. If Newton had kept his observations close to his heart, we would not have known gravity. And when you say knowledge, it need not be only about the subject you have mastered. It could be about life skill, or it could be what you have learnt from your experience. What we have to think is how it's going to benefit others, especially the students. Who are the beneficiaries? How your knowledge is going to help them? So this is how we have to think. So I've started visiting schools and giving a series of talk on how to turn to be a good human being, good citizen, and personality development, and how to prepare for exam without fear. So when I approached one of the school's head teacher, she asked me to take the class. So hundreds of students assembled. Then I spoke on know yourself. I feel that is the first step for the children to develop confidence to face the people, to face the outside world. So that is very important. So it was well received by the students. They liked the topic because it is something they are also interested in knowing. Then I put forth my request that I would like to continue the series of a speech on various topics, starting from know yourself, self-confidence, self-management, and so on. But I didn't get it. Then the other school, the concept was well received and they understood the value of the knowledge, and they were so happy that the beneficiaries are going to be encouraged, and they viewed it from the point of beneficiaries. I like that approach. I continued my visit and spoke to them on various topics. But I'm quite happy with this way of doing service to the society. What happened? I got a call from the school which first I approached. The head teacher asked me to take class within 10 minutes. She asked me to come to her school she gave me very short notice to come to our school and take the classes. And she mentioned that the teachers are not available today. They are all going for a meeting. So all classes are free. You can take all the classes and address the students. So you can take the classes from 9 o'clock to 3 o'clock. So it didn't sound well because it was like taking a substitution. So I was little, I don't say I'm annoyed or anything. That was a very unpleasant way of asking someone who is willing to do service to the school and the students. So I felt sorry for the beneficiaries, because they need, you know, some sort of support from outsiders. They want someone to talk to them, someone to listen to them. That is very needed today, because the teachers have their work, they have already have got their schedule, so it is not possible for them too. So when someone from outside offering this kind of service, when it is rejected, I feel sorry for the students who are the beneficiaries. But it didn't stop me from visiting, because for a second it was a little painful, but then I thought there are so many other children who really want us, who really need this kind of help, and there are other heads of the institutions who welcome us. So I continued my visit and continuing my service, because the knowledge has to be shared. It is not one's own property, so you cannot restrict others from knowing it. So it is a pleasure to share knowledge with others. So definitely, this kind of attitude disturbs us, but we have to continue. So definitely it will not stop me. I'll continue my visit to the schools. So I thought of sharing it with you all, and I don't know what to say, who to blame, and I feel sorry for the students who have been deprived because of elders' attitude.